Tom Nappy here with Hopkinton School Superintendent Dr. Carol Cavanaugh. Dr. Cavanaugh, thanks for joining us today.
Well, thank you for having me.
So how's your summer going, first off?
Well, the summer has been wonderful. A lot of activity in our buildings, getting things ready for students to enter next week. But summer is that time when the administrative team has a little bit of breathing room so that we can prepare, gear up, rest up for the coming school year. So it's been very nice. But right now we are in the week before school begins, and we are, you know, we have our foot down on the accelerator because we're moving quickly.
How are the preparations going and for the new school year?
I think really well. We have a good portion of the roof all repaired at the middle school. Flooring's going in there. The White House renovation looks beautiful. The gym at the high school is absolutely magnificent. The new floor is beautiful. So a lot of those kinds of things have happened, and I think it's, you know, really exciting. Our facilities look, you know, as good as they ever have. So
I'm imagining this is probably the crunch time for you, the next couple of weeks before the school year.
Indeed it is, yes.
Can you talk about the attendance numbers, how the attendance numbers are looking, and is there any concern with any growth?
So our enrollment numbers are huge right now. And I think when we prepared the budget for FY20, we anticipated probably around 103, 104 students coming in. And, you know, those numbers come to us from NESDEC, you know, just looking at some of the houses that would be ready for occupancy according to the planning board, you know, so there are a number of metrics that we use, but not dissimilar from last year. Last year on October 1st, we were somewhere around 186 kids, and we had only planned for 50 kids last year. This year, we had planned for 104, as I said, and we are at 196 today. When we had a school committee meeting last Thursday, so I mean, pretty much all of this happened over the weekend, we were at 191. And at the previous school committee meeting, we might have been around 169-ish. So, yeah, the numbers are climbing, and they are climbing very, very rapidly.
So has that been difficult to deal with and plan for, or is there a plan implemented in place to be able to deal with this okay?
Well, so I think one of the hardships, I guess, is the timing. Right. So what we would hope for is that we would know these numbers in mid-July, because right. Then there might be something more you could do. But when in the last 2 weeks our numbers grow by 26 students, now we have this sort of, oh my gosh, what are we going to do? So we have all along watched our class sizes, and right now the largest class sizes are in grade 5. The fifth grade classrooms are at 24. Mm-hmm. That is higher than we would want them to be. But when you get to this point in the season, if you were to create an additional fifth grade classroom, what that would mean is we would have to have an additional section of PE, so you'd need 0.05 of a PE teacher, of a wellness teacher, of an art teacher, you know, all of those different special areas. And so what we've decided to do is to keep our numbers at 24 and to see if we can't hire some A paraprofessionals. So those are the paraprofessionals who assist in a general education classroom, to get in there and just alleviate a little bit of the stress, if that's the right word, for the gen ed teachers when they're delivering reading instruction or math instruction. So that's really our hope at grade 5. Grades 7, 9, and 11 are all over 300 students. And if I have grade 11 correct, it's 322, and grade 9 is 315. So we have some big numbers, especially
wow.
in the high school.
It must be a little bit overwhelming getting all those students kind of at the last minute there. But of course, the Hopkinton School Administration has always done a great job at dealing with growth. Also going on this summer is the bus loop project. Could you talk a little bit about the bus parking lot project? Could you talk a little bit about the bus parking lot project and what's the progress with that?
I can. So you know that the field that was directly behind the high school was largely unused. It was a great expanse of land, and so at town meeting we received the funds to turn that into a bus parking lot. That work has been done over the summer. I think if you kind of get out there and take a look around, or if folks do, they're going to be very pleased, I think, in what they see. So 5 buses at a time can queue up out there to deboard students, and then what will happen is the buses that need to go immediately to a Hopkins run will leave the parking lot. Those that stick around for a little bit because their Hopkins run has a little bit of wiggle time will remain in the bus parking lot. I think the greatest gain for us as a district is that the buses will all stage back there in the afternoon, and that's the term that we use for parking when the kids are getting in, and then they will come back and park at night, saving us about $50,000 a year in excise tax money. So I would recommend that people get out there and take a look. One thing that I will say to all parents and students, when we are actually busing students in and out of that parking lot, no regular vehicle traffic is allowed in it. So we absolutely can't have that, because it really creates that kind of danger, I think, in having students crossing streets back there. So.
And speaking of traffic, you implemented a new traffic pattern at the high school last year. How did that end up working out last year?
Well, at first, I thought that it was going to be more difficult than it actually was. We were very fortunate. We worked with World Tech Engineering, and they are traffic engineers who helped us design a traffic pattern that would alleviate the stress on Hayden Row. So the goal was to get as many cars off of Hayden Row Street as we possibly could. And they did a really nice job with that. So with the assistance of Chief Lee, school resource officers, Matt Santoro, Ben Stickney, and Phil Powers, we were able to, you know, really move traffic, and obviously Paul DeBona, who's out there, rain, shine, sleet, snow, hail, was probably, you know, the greatest instrument in being able to direct that traffic. So I thought that it worked very well last year. This year we should have about 38 more parking spots up front, and people are going to be able to use not only the old bus loop, but the old drop-off for parent and student drop-off. So I will be getting more information out to families about that shortly.
All right, so what's your plan over the next couple of weeks? So what's gonna be happening over the next couple of weeks?
Well, I think, you know, at this point, it's just really about getting the doors open. Mm-hmm. So, you know, as I've said, all summer long, the custodians are cleaning. And, you know, if you walked into the schools today, you would think, oh, my goodness, look at all of this stuff, because a million deliveries come and there may be, you know, a couple of desks left in hallways and, you know, cleaning receptacles and those kinds of things. But miraculously, they will all disappear before opening day. Today, they're putting in flooring in the White House. So I had gone over this morning to check on that, and they were just beginning, but the flooring company should be out by, you know, 5 o'clock on Wednesday. And so then it's a matter of getting all of the desks and furniture and, you know, those kinds of things ready for the 18 to 22 program. So it's really just, I think we're just in that sort of last minute cleanup right now.
All right. Well, Dr. Cavanaugh, thanks so much for taking the time to give us an update, and we look forward to the upcoming school year.
Thank you very much. Pleasure to let people know where we are, because I think it's just important that people exercise a little bit of patience and understand that we really are on top of it. So,
all right.
Thanks
again.